5 years, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 2, Lesson 2. The topic is Internal Land Forming Processes. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at our lesson goals. We are going to look at the types of the earth movement, and then the features associated with the different types of the earth movement. We start looking at the different types of the earth movement. We have two of them. That is horizontal earth movement, and number two, it is the vertical earth movement. Horizontal earth movement, it is the movement which acts along a plane, but since the earth is curved, these forces act along a tangent. So that is the reason as to why we refer to them as horizontal earth movement, since they operate along a plane. They occur when the earth materials are forced to stretch, shorten, and shear. So it can stretch. That is when now tension force have been applied. And shorten, when compression force have been applied. And shear, when shear or tear force is applied. Remember, these forces are tectonic forces. And tectonic forces, we said they are three. We have the tension force, compression force, and the shear or tear force. These are caused by the forces which pull crust or rocks apart or push them towards each other, but with equal forces on the other crust. As you can be able to see, they diverge. This is the tension force. They converge. It is the compression force. They transform, which is the shear force. From the images, they can show you that. Then they result into the following features. That is the horizontal earth movement result into the following features. We have the fault. We have the rift valley. We also have the basins, the fault scarps, the Brock mountains, and the fault brooks. Like you can be able to see from the diagram. We have the fault scarps, the escarpment, the rift valley. You can be able to see it. The fault brooks, you can be able to see them. We also have the valleys, the escarpment, you can be able to see them, how they occur, the features that result from the horizontal earth movement. Then we go to the second type of the earth movement, which is the vertical earth movement. They are movement which occurs along the radius. And when we are talking about along the radius, it can be either towards the earth's surface or towards its center. So either upward or downward movement. They are caused by strong forces pushing crust or rocks upwards, downwards, or tilting of the rocks. These are the way we are saying they can be forced to move upward or downward. From the diagram, you can be able to see that. Even the other diagram, it can show you how tilting occurs. You can be able to see the way they operate, vertical movement, how it operates. It causes the crust or rocks to move either upward or downward, as the diagram is indicating. Now let us see the features that are formed from the vertical earth movement. We have the normal fault. We also have the reversed fault. We also have the shear or slip fault. All that now you can be able to see from where they are operating. Tension force, compression force, the shear or tear force, still the tectonic forces. Now, they may be caused by the isostatic adjustment. They can also be caused by the emergence and submergence of the coast. Faulting can result, rifting, crust or displacement that result to the following features. We have the basins, we also have the tilt blocks, the fault scarps, the rift valley, the fault blocks, and the plateaus. When you talk about the downward movement, you can be able to see the features that occurs there, submergence of the rudder. It has caused the fault. The trough has been fault. Subsidencing has occurred. Subsidence, that is the cost, submergence of the cost. Then you can be able to see the upward forces, how they operate. You can be able to see the tilt blocks, the Tibet plateaus, how they are formed, the rifting, how it has occurred, and many others. Then that marks the end of our lesson. You can be able to see how they are epigeogenic and orogenic. Those are the two forces. This is the conclusion, the two forces, the two ways in which earth movement occurs. You can be able to see it, epigeogenic and orogenic. Then we have the features. The assignment activity for today, you can be able to see it there. So two types of the earth movement. Then I write the features that result from the vertical earth movement. Then for more information, you can get us from the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube, from the Facebook, and the Twitter. Stay tuned to Erin TV. Thank you for watching.